What we got here is a trajectory to this point. Now, from an ordnance position on the roof of that apartment building, we got an A and B prime target area here. The head of the shell, after piercing this outer plate, will melt the bell crank and free these, lugs. Now, then one guy's gonna jump through the hole and jerk out the lugs with a pipe wrench. Additionally, we'll have two guys in the room wearing protective asbestos suits, mind you, during impact, just in case the secondary explosion sets fire to the contents of the vault. Now, as far as getting a weapon up on that roof over there, I've dealt with that problem without using any winches.
Hold it, just a minute. You want to fire a cannon off the roof of that building?
No, it ain't a cannon. It's an M91A anti-tank gun. It's a bazooka.
A bazooka?
Yeah.
Where are you going to get one of them things, a bazooka?
Well, for Christ's sakes, every army in the state's got one. We'll boost it.
You ever heard the sound one of them things makes?
Hey, I was an Omaha Beach fella. I heard every goddamn gun they make. Howitzers, 44s, you name it.
Hey, wait a minute, mister. Just a second. You want to blast that Pete with a cannon? You got to have a hole in your marble bag. What about the bug?
That involves a separate offensive, synchronized with the impact of the shell. At that exact instant, a squad of seven men is going to raid the ADT headquarters with machine guns. Now, a couple of grenades will take out the switch panel, and the cops won't get no alarms. Now, of course, we might have to kill a few of the ADT employees, but I don't see no way around that, do you?